May I request all the dignitaries to be seated now? May I now request Honorable Vice President of India, Shri Venkaiah Naidu sir, to kindly address us all present here today.
Photographer. Managing photographers and politicians is the biggest thing. Sabhi ko namaskar. Sarvana namaskara. Anivarikum vanakkam. Yadariku namaskara. Yadavarikum namaskara. Andariki namaskaram. Badane namaste. Satsri akal. Saukadeki namaste. Samastaku namaskar. Okuroki namaskar. Brothers and sisters from the film fraternity, the youngsters who have shown an extraordinary talent, the awardees, officials of the Information Broadcasting Ministry, and the other guests who have been invited today, I deem it an honor to be here in the august presence of all of you on this special occasion of the 66th National Film Awards. These prestigious awards reflect the richness and diversity of the Indian film industry. I would like to convey my heartiest congratulations to all the awardees, award winners. My congratulations to Sri Amitabh Bachchan, the Dayan of the Indian film industry, for being awarded the prestigious Dada Saheb Phalke Award. I'm sorry that you could not be physically present with us for the ceremony because of indisposition. I hope that you would bounce back to good health soon. It would be no exaggeration to say that Sri Amitabh Ji is an institution by himself. For more than 5 decades, he has been enthralling the masses in India and abroad by essaying different roles, from an angry young man to an aging parent. Bachchanji continues to be a perennial source of inspiration to the entire Indian film industry. He has taken this as a mission. I appeal to all of you in the film industry, please treat this as a mission and do it with passion. Do not allow any omission or do not give any remission. That should be the mission for all of us, so that you can excel and you can enthrall the people and also motivate the people. I must thank our esteemed jury for having collectively decided on the list of distinguished awardees. It must have been quite an intensive, immersive experience to watch more than 400 entries in the feature film category and 255 entries in the non-feature categories and select the most socially relevant and aesthetically deserving films. It's an odious task. I'm also aware of it because I happen to be sometime IB minister. I noticed that the non-feature films deal with a wide range of subjects, from female infanticide to the challenges faced by the viewers. They tell stories of brave human trafficking survivors, about the ethics of adoption, films mapping the journey of our fictional characters to real-life heroes like late Sri G.D. Naidu. The feature films this year are as much about emotions as they are about intelligence. We have gifted child artists among us who have shown us infinite range of emotions without creating commotions and doing their promotions for our happiness. In the banquet of films, we have films that break stereotypes and attack superstitions sensitively. We see through the maker's imagination. The orthodox traditions give way to the modern solutions. It also gives me great pleasure to know that the award for the best feature film goes to a film on women's struggle. It is a story of a woman working together to overcome the challenges of their oppressive surroundings. We have a separate great tradition. Adikal se, Vedakal se, Puranakal se, Punyakal se, Parapurojana jiya aur diya virasat mein humko mila. Stri ko matru murti ke roop mein hum log hamesha mante the. Beech mein jo bhi hua, uske unke karan se, jo mulyon mein giravat aaya, isko dobara mulyon ko upar lane ka bahut zaruri hai. Ye keval sarkar ke upar nirbhar nahi kar sakte. And this cannot be left to government alone, beti bachao, beti padao, beti badao. But all of us in the society, and particularly in the film industry, they must promote, depict women in a respectable manner. The women in India were always given importance from the ancient times. If you believe in Puranas, I am not suggesting that you should believe in Purana, that is left to you. Saraswati, education minister. I am saying it in a lighter. Parvati, defense. Lakshmi, finance. That is the importance even among Devi Devatas also. So that is our tradition. And all the rivers in this country, Ganga, Yamuna, Kaveri, Saraswati, Mahanadi, Mahendra Tanaya, Narmada, Tapati, Sebari, you take any river, rivers are named after women. That shows the civilizational importance they used to give to women. We must try to re-establish it and re-inculcate among our children, youngsters, the respect for women, because they constitute 50% of the population of the country. I am not speaking about reservation. I am talking of the preservation of our culture. That is what is required. And cinema has a great role in influencing the mind of the people. We have seen, unfortunately, the atrocious things that are happening against women here and there. It happened. We have seen the Nirbhaya Prakaran also, unfortunately. What is required is not a mere new bill. There is a clamor. Anything happening anywhere, people demand, sir, new bill, new bill. I remember it happened in 2012. I was a member of parliament. I told Mr. Chairman, of course, I am the chairman now of the Rajya Sabha, but at that time I was a member. I told Mr. Chairman, said, you want to speak? I said, no, I don't want to speak. I want to make one point. I said, what is required is not a new bill. What is required is political will, administrative skill, go for the kill of the social evil. That is what is required. This is evil, social evil, which has come in between. We must see to it that we end it. And here, I feel the cinema has an important role, because the cinema is the most powerful communicator in the modern society. The TV, the cinema. That's why I particularly mention about that feature film on women's struggle. It's a story of women working together to overcome the challenge of their oppressive surroundings. There's a vast range of films in these awards. We have awards that bring to us the best of sound and the best of silence. Because there is a complaint nowadays in public life, in cinema, voice is becoming less and noise is becoming more. Sangeetamu takkuva, sahityamu takkuva, vaidyamu ekkuva ayipoyindani cheppani some people are complaining. So the sound has got its own importance. Sound that takes us back to small Indian villages, towns and cities. Awards in various Indian languages that capture our culture. Awards which raise our awareness about environment. Awards that raise questions and others that offer solutions. We must promote our Indian languages. Our cultural richness is there in the languages. Prakashji was talking about regional. I call all of them as Indian languages. Nothing is regional. They are national languages. That's why all these awards for different languages and all. Because language and culture go together. Bhasha aur bhavana ek saath chalta hai. So we must see to it that we promote our Indian languages. Language is like a eyesight. Matru bhasha, your mother tongue, is like your eyesight. And the other language is like spectacles. If you have eyesight, spectacles will give you better sight. Otherwise, you will not have any sight. So that way, loving mother tongue. So maa ka garbh se aaya matru bhasha ho, Telugu ho, Tamil ho, Kannada ho, Malayali ho, Marathi ho, Assami ho, Punjabi ho, Bhojpuri ho, Dogri ho, Urdu ho, jo bhi bhasha. Ye Bharatiya bhashaon ko protsahan karna, jeevit rakhna, ek daitva keval sarkar ka nahi, hamare samaj ka bhi hai, aur samaj mein cinema ka mahatvapurna bhumika hai. That's why I'm happy that the ministry has instituted awards for different Indian languages. I feel that there are huge opportunities for greater cooperation between the film fraternity and the government to devise ways to utilize the scenic endowments of India. I am glad to know that the state of Uttarakhand has won the award for being the most film-friendly state. I must congratulate the government in facilitating the ease of film making in the state. My compliments to Uttarakhand government. While collectively striving for sustainable development, we can promote the tourism sector and showcase India's cultural diversity to the world. Dear sisters and brothers, as you are all aware, cinema is not only the most popular medium of entertainment, but also the most impactful. Right from Raja Harishchandra, the first movie made in India in 1913, films have caught the popular imagination and earned a special place in the hearts of the people. Cinema has no geographical or religious boundaries because it speaks a universal language and touches the raw emotions. Raj Kapoorji's Awara Hoon continues to be popular in Russia even today. Over the years, Indian movie from Bollywood and other languages, Indian languages have earned global popularity. I have been going around the globe. Recently, I have been to some Baltic countries and also African countries, Latin American countries. There they were telling, they were showing interest. Because of three things. One, culture. They're all impressed by Indian culture. Second is cinema. Third is cuisine. The Indian food, the Indian cinema is catching up everywhere in the world. And I would like to congratulate all of you who are promoting the cinema and showcasing it in the world. It's a very, very important communication system which speaks about our greatness and the talent that is there hidden in everybody is taken out by the cinema and then exhibited in a better manner. So this Indian cinema, Indian culture, Indian cuisine, the food also. The food is so, what do you call, rich. And I don't know, the younger generation, some of us are getting sorely tempted with the Western food, fast food, junk food. And I would like to suggest that we should also promote, because the International Health Magazine's latest report says two things. One is the reason for spread of non-communicable diseases in a big manner is, one, lifestyle changes. No activity, no physical activity, no movement at all. So physical fitness, Fitness India, or yoga, whatever it, yoga is for your body, not because of Modi. You have to understand that. Modi is... Yoga brings unity of mind and body. And physical fitness makes you fit. If you are physically fit, then you will be mentally alert. See, at this age also, the fitness of Amitabh Bachchan to Ayushman Khurrana to Akshay Kumar. See them, really surprised. What is this thing? Because of physical fitness. That is very important, and of course, physical fitness is very important in cinema. I need not explain it. This is one thing. That is second about the food. Food is weakness is developing, and so much faster the non-communicable diseases are increasing. I am talking with the scientific, authentic information. And I would like to caution my countrymen. I would like cinema also to pass on this message. We must eat time-tested food. Don't worry. I am going to prescribe some food code and all. No food code, no dress code. Whatever you want to wear, wear something. That's all. I don't say anything. Eat something. But eat proteinous food. Eat proteinous food. Some people say, sir, instant food. Instant food means constant disease. You have to understand. Food cannot be instant, na? Wood has to be cooked. For thousands of years, our forefathers, they have learnt it by experience. And they have suggested you have so many items in India. There is no dearth of items in India. Thousands of items are there. And they are becoming universally popular, but some of us are, because of the naming, because of the branding, because of some icon says something, this is good, pizza, burger. They may be good for those countries, but what is good for our season? What is good for our reason? What is good for our region? That has to be under, not religion, region. Region. And how the marketing say, you go to restaurant and give a card, they give a card, give all attractive names, chicken 65. The fellow's age is not even 25. And he is running after 65. Why I am saying it in a lighter manner with all seriousness, because the Indian children should be educated about good food habits, because we have a demographic dividend. 65% of the Indian population, as on now, as per the official estimates, is below 35 years. 50% of the Indian population are below 25 years. They are the future. So they should take care of the fitness, their physical fitness as well as mental fitness also. During my visit, as I was saying, I was surprised to found the popularity of Indian films. In fact, one of the top dignitaries of a Baltic country told me how they enjoyed watching Bollywood movies. And in the recent times, films like Bahubali have proved that India's film industry is capable of making technically superior movies. Over the years, cinema has become an integral part of our cultural consciousness. The staggering number of films made in different languages in our country every year is a testimony not only to the popularity of films, but also to the fact that the film industry provides a livelihood to thousands of families across the country. Since films can make profound impact on the society, I feel that cinema should act as an instrument of social change. Dowry, harassment of women, atrocities against women, promoting girls' education, per drop more crop, Fitness India, promoting our agriculture. All these things should become social movements. They are not political, they are not afraid to one party or other. What is required is to make them into Janandolan. There, the role of the media is also, we were talking of pad man, we are talking of sanitation, we are talking of women's empowerment, we are talking of so many things. I'm very happy that so many awards are given to various messages, and also there is a meaning. Some people feel cinema is for entertainment, sir. Who will see the message and all? No. You have number of examples. Just now also we saw some of them. Cinema with a message not only entertains people, but also enlighten people, impress upon the people. So there is a need to promote more socially relevant issues while giving quality entertainment to the people. My dear brothers and sisters, I would like to suggest to the film fraternity, the cinema should act not only as an entertainer, but also instrument of social change. Art speaks a universal language. This language reaches the hearts and minds of people very easily. It communicates emotions, transmits values, and helps shape social norms. It influences behavior and can alter perceptions. It can incite people and excite passions or calm ruffled nerves and provide solace to troubled minds. It gives solace to the troubled mind. That 3 hours you go to cinema, you will get solace, you will get comfort, you will get peace, you will get joy, you will get happiness, you will get calmness, because cinemas. So cinema should keep that message in mind. It can make us laugh wholeheartedly and shed tears copiously. It can make you laugh and it can make you weep. That much power is there with the cinema. Art does not merely copy what happens within society, but also imagines the future and indirectly shapes a society. In a way, it not only provides wholesome entertainment, but also performs an educative function. In my view, the filmmaker should also be conscious of the impact this powerful medium has on the people. The effort should be to educate people and promote social harmony. The focus should be on creating an artistic rendition of challenges and social ills and resolve the conflicts in a way that reinforces social cohesion and ethical principles. We have a great culture, we have different languages, we have more than 1,000 languages. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Vividhata mein ekata, Bharat ka visheshata. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. Atak se lekar Katak tak, Kanyakumari se lekar Kashmir tak, we are India. Simply saying Vande Mataram or saying Jai Hind or Bharat Mata ko Jai will not suffice. Bharat Mata ko Jai maane, Bharat desh mein rahane wale sabhi logon ko Jai ho. Forward ho, backward ho. Muslim ho, Christian ho, Hindu ho. Believer ho, non-believer ho. That is not the issue. All of us, they should feel that they are equal partners in the development of the country in every sphere of the public activity. That should be our effort. That is the real Jai Hind. That is the real Vande Mataram. That is the real Bharat Mata Ko Jai. Mere slogan alone will not be. You have to promote unity and integrity, and you must work for the safety, security and sovereignty of the nation. This has to be understood by all. The film medium should strive to bring about an attitudinal change in the society, and has been done in quite a few films on many contemporary issues like sanitation, gender parity and caste discrimination. It is really shameful, after 70 years of this great country's developmental agenda, there are still some areas where there is discrimination on the basis of caste, discrimination on the basis of region, discrimination based on gender, discrimination based on certain things. There may be few, but they should be curbed. And the way is to bring a social change and attitudinal change. We must convey a strong message to combat the current trend of violence against women. Violence in the society. Violence. Silence is no good. You have to come out. But violence also is no good. And for that, as I told you, you can't get, some people say, sir, the law, some people say court should give the type of treatment that is given in one of the states in the recent days. You cannot give instant justice, but you cannot allow constant delays. This has to be understood by one and all. I hope the people who are concerned with this, they will understand this. I was extremely disturbed, like every right-minded citizen of the country, by the incidents of rape and violence against women in some parts of the country, and also the incidents of violence that are taking place in certain places. It's no good. It's our own country. It's independent India. It's your own country. So people should develop positive mindset, positive. And they should not get into obstruction, destruction. Everybody should think in terms of construction. I am not saying everybody should support the government. No need. Dissent is the essence of democracy. Agree to disagree. Agree to disagree. Agree to disagree. This has to be followed by one and all, right from parliamentarians to the ordinary people. Everybody should follow discipline. Everybody should follow decorum and enhance the image and prestige of the country, every walk of life. That's why I tell my parliamentarians also, please, if you want to talk out, talk out. You don't want to agree with the government, you want to vote out, vote out. Or you want to walk out, walk out. But don't create all out for democracy by obstruction. Obstruction is not going to help. So this mindset has to change among the people. Then one person said, sir, do you mean to say that we should support the government? I said, who asked you to support the government? Let the government propose. Let the opposition oppose. Let the house dispose. At the end of the day, house members, they have to dispose. They will give verdict. You have to accept in democracy. Verdict of the people is uppermost. And you must, some people say tolerance. Tolerance towards the mandate of the people. Tolerance towards the other's view. Tolerance towards the other point of view. That you should be tolerant. Everybody has to be tolerant. It's not the simply, it's a fashion for some people to say one has to be tolerant and all. But at the same time, any action does, anything said should be in the interest of the nation to which you belongs to. You cannot have the luxury of going against your own nation and then creating tension and then creating emotions. That should not be our promotion. India is the biggest USP of India, my dear friends. I have been sharing it with the cinema people. Biggest USP of India is the family system. Family. Grandmother, grandfather, father, mother, brother, sister, all living together. What an amount of happiness. The world always looks to India's family system. And then now what is happening? We are seeing disintegration. We must build up family values. Cinema is one such instrument. The second USP is the India's basic philosophy is Vasudhaika Kutumbakam. Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. We must promote that attitude among our people. This is what our forefathers have told us, and we must promote it. And this is done by parents and grandparents, by the society, by the industry, and also by the leaders. Everyone should move in that direction. Cinema too can play a major role in promoting the right values. It is probably wrong to think that a message-oriented film would not be accepted by the audience. A film with a social message can be entertaining and commercially successful as well. In the recent years, Three Idiots was one such film. Just because I don't see much of the films, I don't have time, as Prakash Ji was telling, and I only see once in a way some films which I am told are good, and also try to really meet, of course I meet people in the cinema industry frequently because of my location and my background of being the southern this thing, and cinema and Telugu is the most popular thing, is the maximum number of cinemas. They are there in my state. I think some 2,000 plus cinemas are there. So I interact with them. So I appeal to the filmmakers and others in the film industry to take the lead in curbing violence, obscenity, and vulgarity in the films. These are the three things. Obscenity, vulgarity, and violence. The film should be such, you must be able to go with your daughter, with your wife, and with your mother, go to the cinema hall, enjoy the film, then that is the film is really good film according to me. If you are not able to, then you have to leave your kids. You don't want to leave your kids, but the rest of the cinema, you want to show whatever you want to show. You want to think. This is not a question of censorship. What I suggest is not the censorship. Censorship. To have some sense. If there is no sense, then it will create nonsense and then become a new sense, and people lose the sense. So we must have that sense-ship, that is to see that the values, the traditions, the culture, the heritage and maintained, and social harmony is achieved by that. Violence has no place in a democracy. Every filmmaker must make a conscious effort to ensure that the dialogues, depiction of characters and costumes reflect Indian culture, customs, practices, traditions. Cinema should also help in strengthening family systems and promoting democratic governance. As a matter of fact, cinema industry should not to do anything that weakens the culture, traditions, values. Many of the cinemas are promoting Bharatiyata, Indianness. There is a beauty. And there is no question of Indianness. Ye to purana hai, ye to ye hai, yo. Aisa nahi hai. I will just give you one small example. When I became vice president, media people came to me and asked me, sir, what about the dress? I said, what? Dress, sir? I said, what is the dress? Sir, now you are vice president, second constitutional authority. Mujhe malum tha wo kya puchna chahte the, fir bhi maine kaha kya batao? I said, dress, sir? I said, no change of dress, only change of address. From Abdul Kalam Road to Che Maulana Ajad Road. And I'm maintaining my dress only, except in extreme weather conditions. And nobody is looking down, bhai, ye kya ye aadmi aisa? Gaon wala aadmi aisa dikh rahe? No. Recently there was a conference of 120 nations, NAM, non-aligned meet. I was the only man. I think one man, exception was the Saudi, Iran leader. Normal dress. Everybody was looking at me, and then they were all smiling and appreciating, not laughing, appreciating. So see, our traditions and our culture depiction will get affection. Don't worry on that count. But I am not suggesting that you should follow this particular dress, follow this particular food. No, these are all left to you. We are a free country. But do whatever is good for you and good for the society. So Bharatiyata ko bhi kayam rakana jimmedari Bharatiya cinema pe hai. I once again congratulate all the award winners present here today. This is a wonderful moment of celebration, a moment of pride in our past achievements, and a moment of buoyant optimism that makes us excited about future opportunities. I am hopeful that the year 2020 will see an ever-increasing sense of artistic and creative fulfillment as Indian cinema continues quest for greater heights of excellence. I just quote one line said by the Prime Minister. He gave a three-line advice to all: reform, perform, and transform. Transformation of the nation, transformation of the lives of the people, transformation. Give them joy, give them happiness, give them the needed proper guidance. That is the advice in our own way. Such a wonderful creativity is there among actors, actress, writers, dialogue writers, screenplay, producers. Of course, they bear the consequences. Producers, they have to be careful. But all other creativity, every creativity, we have wonderful experience in our country. Wonderful. So many great examples are there. Even upcoming also. Recently, I happened to see the film in which one of the actress sitting here acted, Mahanati. That is great actress. Name of the film. Savitri, some of the film personalities must be remembering her. One of the great, great actress those days. But a new actress, an young girl from Kerala, Kirti, Suresh. The way he acted and the maturity she has shown in acting is amazing. That means there is talent. You have to properly guide. You have to properly guide, give encouragement. Then children also you are seeing now. How confident they are. So there is a lot of talent in the country. Let us tap the talent for positive manner and encourage them. These prestigious awards are an effort to recognize the talent, to promote the talent. So I would like to compliment the Ministry, Prakash Javadekar ji, and his other team members for organizing this function, and also would like to thank all the other participants who are all there in this function and who gave me a very patient hearing. I would appeal to each one of you to see that our standards, our values, our culture is maintained and proper message goes to the people. Thank you very much. Namaskar, Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir. Aapki hausla afzai ke liye.